Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Electrolux after the home appliance manufacturer missed second quarter earnings expectations. It reported an 8% drop in sales due to weak demand. Electrolux shares are trading in negative territory at 126.90 Swedish krona each. Also in focus, shares of Swedish automaker Volvo, which reported a 54% plunge in its second quarter earnings. Volvo car shares last traded in the red at 49.08 Swedish krona apiece. We're also keeping a close watch on Johnson & Johnson shares. The company's second quarter revenue and earnings topped Wall Street's expectations owing to strong sales in its medtech business. Johnson & Johnson shares are up over 1% in pre-market trade. Here are some local corporate headlines. 7-Eleven posted a record net income of over 2 billion pesos in 2022. Philippine 7 President and CEO Jose Victor Paterno notes, people are buying more products despite shopping less frequently. The company aims to open 400 new stores this year, allotting 3.7 billion pesos in total capex. Philippine 7 shares stayed flat in Thursday trade. BPI also posting a jump in net income. Its second quarter net profit rose 4.5% to 13 billion pesos. This brought the bank's net income to 25.1 billion in the first half. That's a 23% uptick, which the bank attributes to average asset base expansion, margin growth, and lower provisions. BPI shares close up 1% in today's trade. Meanwhile, Globe launches its prepaid fiber broadband service in a bid to attract lower-income families to shift to fiber internet. Its CEO, Ernest Koo, says this could be a big growth driver for the telecom. The telecom giant shares jumped 2.3% in today's trade. Double Dragon's Hotel 101 signs master service agreements with three Spanish advisory firms, making them exclusive advisory service providers for buyers of the hotel's Madrid properties. The firm specializes in Spain's so-called Golden Visa program, offering investors residency or citizenship in exchange for an investment. Double Dragon shares rose 0.6% in today's trade. And the Supreme Court denies a group's petition to block water concessionaire Maynilad's plans to build a combined drainage system. The High Court said the petition lacks basis. Metro Pacific Investment shares stayed flat in today's trade, while DMCI shares dropped 0.2%.
Asian markets ended Thursday trade mostly lower as investors digested a slew of economic data. Japan's Nikkei slumped 1.2% despite the country reporting a trade surplus for the first time in nearly 2 years. Chinese shares also posting losses. It's after the Bank of China held its 1 and 5 year loan prime rates unchanged. Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of TSMC fell after the world's biggest chipmaker reported a 23% fall in profit, its first drop in 4 years. This is as a global demand slump in chips continue. Meanwhile, Reliance Industries of Indian billionaire Mukesh Ambani closed 1.6% higher after earlier seeing its shares fall in a special pre-open call session. The special trading session was held to set the stock price of Reliance spin-off Jio Financial following their demerger. The price, 261.85 Indian rupees, which values Jio Financial at $20 billion. Now, with that valuation, the company would be one of the top 40 Indian companies by market capitalization in a list headed by Reliance. Here at home, Philippine shares outperformed, with the main index rising more than 1% to settle back above the 6,600 level. Aaron Tsai of First Metro Pacific says the market holding support is a good sign, but he adds more good news is needed to improve foreign buying.
So far, the foreigners are still in the net selling position for the year, a trend that we have been seeing for several years already, you know, which is also the reason why some analysts and investors are banking on the low exposure of foreigners in the local equities versus historical average. So somehow revert to the mean, you know, and look forward to foreigners pouring money into our market soon. But that was also the expectation last year, you know, and it didn't happen. Question is, when will it happen?
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urged to allow lands given to farmer beneficiaries to be leased by big agri-corporations. Private sector lead for jobs and Go Negosyo founder Joey Concepcion says this could help make Filipino farmers more competitive and improve the agriculture sector in the country.
Unless we fix agriculture, the Philippines will not be competitive. What we need to do is to create scale. Once this titling and ownership is cleared, the lands should be allowed to be leased by these farmers to the bigger corporations. They can provide the mentorship, they can provide also the market. And pag ganyan, yung mga banko, siyempre magpapuutang na rin sa kanila kasi tama ang business model ng mga maliit na negosyante na ito, mga farmers. No? So, yeah, that is very important, is access to mentorship, money, and market, even in the agri sector.